Often a data table contains one or more columns that indicate date and time values, yet they are often defined as string columns. There are many operations that are useful to carry out specific to columns of type date and time, such as filtering data to a specific time range, calculating the duration between records in the consecutive rows, shifting dates, etc. So to be able to do these kinds of operations, we first have to convert the string values to date and time. We can do this with the string to date and time node. Here we have a workflow that reads in sales data from two different files and concatenates them into one table. The first file has the dates of the orders in a column of type date and time. The second file has the dates of the orders in a string column. Before we can concatenate the orders from these two tables and then perform other pre-processing tasks on the data, we first have to convert this column to date and time. Let's open the configuration dialog of the string to date and time node. Here above, we see all the string columns. We select the order date column that we want to convert to date and time and exclude the others. In the next section, we select the replace selected columns option because we want to replace the column with the dates as string. If we selected this append selected columns option, we would append a new column with the dates in a date and time format. Here below, we have more detailed date and time options to select from. Possible options are date, time, date and time, and date and time with zone. In our case, the dates of the orders are reported in years, months, dates, followed by a time, so we select date and time in the menu. Next, we define the date format. This means which characters in the string correspond to years, which characters to months, and so on. If the date format is one of the standard formats, we can select the corresponding format here in the menu. In our case here, we have first years, then months and days, separated by a hyphen, then capital T, and finally hours and minutes, separated by a colon. Time values at greater granularity are inside brackets, which means that they are optional. Here we can see the first value in the selected string column, so we can check that the selected date format matches the characters in the string. Instead of selecting the correct data type here and the correct date format here in this menu, we can try to auto-guess the correct type and format by clicking this Guess Data Type and Format button. If we convert strings that have written terms, such as weekdays or month names, then we use this Local option to define the language and the region. By checking this Fail on Error option, we force the node to fail if the conversion doesn't work. If we uncheck this option, missing values will be generated for values that cannot be converted. The node configuration is now finished, so we click OK. When we check the output table, we see that the node has converted the order date column of type string to the type date and time. In this video, we have shown how to convert columns of type string that contain date and time values to columns of type date and time, so that we can perform operations that are only possible with columns of this type. Many different date formats are supported. We just have to define which characters in the string values correspond to which granularity. In many cases, the manual configuration can be replaced by auto-guessing the data type and format.